Hey! So, Ben Stein, you made that Expelled, No Intelligence Allowed documentary about intelligence design and the supposed oppression of people who dare question Darwinism. First of all, no Darwinism, that really doesn't exist. Evolution, yes. Darwinism, no. People don't care about the person, they just care about the ideas. In fact, the ideas have been supported by 150 years of scientific evidence. And as nonsensical as his documentary seems to be, Ben Stein himself seems to be kind of going off the deep end. And I've been thinking a lot about this, because I have several problems of my own that I have to deal with. So I've been thinking a lot about this, and for a while I was certainly thinking, like most people are thinking, and is the easy thing to think, that he's got a little bit nutters. Maybe some senile stuff going on there. I mean, he's an older guy, maybe. Who knows? Maybe he's losing his grip on reality. I don't think it's that simple. You have this movie, first of all, which makes all these bold, crazy claims, and like, oh, Darwinism makes Nazism possible. Never mind the fact that artificial selection is what was used in Nazis' purge of Jewish people, not natural selection, because under nature, you wouldn't have the SS coming and gassing people. Just a little thought. More of an animal husbandry thing than anything else. Maybe farming is what enabled Nazis spread, huh? Huh? You gonna stop growing corn, Ben Stein? People who grow corn support Nazis. Yeah, I said it. Aside from the claims of the movie, he's been on a bit of a press tour making equally and even more bizarre claims, such that he really seems like kind of he's lost it. Like in one place, when he's talking, say, on the Greg Kilburn show, making jokes that you have to be high to watch the movie and that Darwinism doesn't explain gravity or physics or how the planets in the sky and thusly the theory's false. That's not what the theory's about, dude. It's evolution as a theory describes the diversity of life on the planet, and that's it. That's all. No one ever said that it would, you know, explain gravity or astrology or physics or the economy or why the map is the way the map is or anything like that. It's just the development of species, dude. But then he goes on these religious shows and starts spouting this like craziness, like science leads you to killing people, but if you go on the religion, if you go to God, Christian God, of course, then that's divine. And people should watch the movie to find out that they are part of the divine and not just a spark of lightning in a mud puddle or something, which is totally a misrepresentation of evolutionary theory, and he knows it. Dude, God, dude! And he goes to this other place, and he's saying these other things, he's being really, really weird and inconsistent in every single episode. It seems like he's almost got, like, multiple personalities. And for a while I was thinking, you know, this guy just doesn't get the internet. Allow me to back up and give you some historic context for what I'm talking about. When Kennedy was running against Nixon for the presidential race, part of the reason Kennedy won, they say, is that Kennedy looked good on TV. And at that point, TV was new enough that they didn't realize that that was going to matter. So you have this handsome, well-spoken, charismatic guy, Kennedy, he's like, I would like to make this country better. And then on the other side, you have this short, sweaty, sallow-eyed kind of gentleman named Nixon going, oh, I don't really know what I'm doing in front of the camera. And Kennedy won. Likewise, Ben Stein, I think, is playing up to the crowd. So he's going to this talk show where everything's light, and he's treating it light. He goes to this religious show, and this guy's already hating science, so he's saying, science is all evil, and he's going over here going like, oh, I also think racism is awesome. So he just doesn't realize, I don't think, because he's an old guy, he's been around for a while, his time is gone. It's way over there. You can't even see it anymore. It's so far gone. He's old. Also, his ears are kind of weird, but that's an ad hominem attack. Has nothing to do with the accuracy of his claims. The facts have everything to do with the accuracy of his claims, and he has none. So that's what I thought for a while, that it was simply a case of this gentleman not understanding that people were going to record this and show it to other people, and it was going to get up on the internet and other people could watch it, and also that people would have access to something called Wikipedia and to be able to, like, research all of the obscene claims in the movie, and that, you know, people would get it debunked. And I think actually at this point, considering the dismal box office, like 5 million over 2 weeks, which is horrible, that more people have actually been exposed to the debunking of the film than the film itself, then I realized, that's not it at all. I had an epiphany. It was like a brainstorm. It was like, pow! Expelled, No Intelligence Allowed, is actually a really, 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 really clever plant by secularists. Think about it. it's supposedly the greatest argument they have for intelligent design, right? And you have this guy who's like, people are believing him because he's like, drops in a drone. He's like, anyone have more facts than me? And they're making all these like ridiculous mistakes. Like they're stealing music, stealing animation, lying to their guests, totally faking and misrepresenting what the documentary is about. Let me put it this way. If you were going to make a movie that was a parody of the movie that an intelligent design person, the stereotype of intelligent designer, would make, it would be this movie, exactly as it is. You wouldn't need to change frame. And this is supposed to be their crowning achievement. Oh, you know, God had come down himself and blessed this film. And it stinks, and no one's believing it. And they're just making a mockery of themselves. The only question is, how far does the deception go? Like, I wonder if Ben Stein was chosen not because he's authoritative, because he really isn't, but because he is so nuts that they knew that whatever argument they're trying to make, he would just blow it out of the water with his own insanity and incompetence, right? I mean, they probably really lied to Eugenie Scott, Richard Dawkins, and the like, because that makes sense, right? Because then they're going to get genuinely upset at the film. And then you have Ben Stein going, blah, 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 science leads to killing, blah, 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 blah. Nazism is a natural thingy of the thingy, you know? But we have you, and you have this movie that's so handily discredited as it is being touted as the big thing in the movement. I think Ben Stein just destroyed the movement. So thank you, Ben Stein and Mark Mathis, for creating a movie that demonstrates that intelligent design has no place in the school system whatsoever. If I see you two, I will buy you a beer. Funny thing, I'm not even real and I make more sense than he does.